Hello all, welcome to my channel. In case you are watching for the first time, this is a channel on engineering studies focusing more on electrical and electronics engineering. Please check description link for more videos. Also, please like, share and subscribe. Do click on bell icon to get notified as I upload new videos on every day. I also have another channel related to competitive examination preparation. Please support it by sharing with your friends. You can find the link in the description box as well. Let us move on to the discussion. In this session, I'll be discussing most important power system questions which can be expected for various state level PSC, SSC, then GATE examination and IES exam. This will be helpful for especially electrical, electronics and instrumentation engineering students. Let us move on to the session. Let us go through the first question. The sequence components of the fault current are as follows. The positive sequence current I positive is equal to J1.5 per unit. I negative is equal to minus J0.5 per unit. I zero is equal to minus 1 JPU. The type of fault in the system is line to ground, line to line, double line to ground and triple LG, or you can call three phase fault, triple LG fault. So which is the right answer? The right answer for this particular question is, you can able to see I positive is equal to negative of I negative. So if I see this kind of relation, I should go for double LG fault. Option C is the right answer. And also I would like to add one more point in this particular question, which is the severe most fault. Three phase fault is the most severe fault you have to identify. And one more point I wanted to add with this statement, which is the most likely happening fault. That is line to ground fault. This type of fault is actually most frequently happening the fault in power system. So I hope the concept is clear. Moving on to the next question. A negative sequence relay is commonly used to protect an alternator, transformer, transmission line, bus bar. Actually, the negative sequence relay is most used for the alternator, or you can call AC generator. For transformer, Buckholz relay is actually most suitable for transformer. So let us continue the discussion. Out of the following plant categories, nuclear, second one is runoff, third one is pump storage, and fourth one is diesel. The base load power plant are A, B, C, D, which is the correct answer in your opinion. So I have, in the last session, I have discussed the difference between peak load power plant as well as base load power plant. So base load power plant will be operating 24 hours. Okay. So among the list, the following are the base load power plant, nuclear and runoff river, where pump storage and diesel power plants are basically peak load power plant to satisfy the peak demand. So from this context, I have to pick out what are the major options corresponding to base load. So I have to go for option A, that is 1 and 2. Nuclear and runoff plants are belong to the base load power plant, where pump storage and diesel power plant are peak load power plant. Please read the next question, very important. For a fixed value of complex power flow in a transmission line having a sending end voltage is V, the real power loss will be proportional to. First of all, you have to know about complex power. S is equal to VI star. So that is called complex power. You can represent it as P plus JQ. P plus JQ. Okay. That is equal to S, complex power, where P is known as real power and Q is known as reactive power. Now, I wanted to separate the value of I. So let me separate the value of I. I'll be showing you the next slide I have written over there. So from the slide, you can able to say that I is equal to I star, I is equal to P plus JQ by V, or else I star conjugate, that is equal to P minus JQ divided by V. I can write in this manner. If I take the magnitude, then I'll be getting I is equal to square root of P square plus Q square divided by V. Suppose, what is the equation for real power loss? P loss is equal to real power loss. I can write the equation I square into R. Most of the transmission line losses will be like this only. So what you can do is, so instead of I can substitute this particular value. So what I'll be doing is square root of P square plus Q square. Okay. Whole divided by V, the whole square into R. That is equal to P loss. I can write like this. So from this relation, you have to elaborate. That means the square root of P square plus Q square, the whole square divided by V square into R square. So from this relation, I can able to write P loss is directly proportional to 1 by V square, or else I can write the P loss is inversely proportional to V square. So please go through the equation. Sorry, please go through the relation in the particular question. Let me turn back that particular question and I'll be showing you. Okay. So that means here the power loss is proportional to 1 divided by V square, or you can call power loss is inversely proportional to what I can say, V square. So as per the question, the power loss will be proportional to 1 by V square. Obviously, I have to go for option C. I think it is clear to you. So I wanted to discuss one more question. That is also very important. You can expect in gate level examination. Match the items in the list 1 with the items in the list 2 and select the correct answer using the codes given below in the list. So you can able to see list 1 and list 2 respectively. The list 1, we are having improved power factor, reduce the current ripple, increase the power flow in line, reduce the Faraday effect. Next list comprises of shunt list, shunt reactor, shunt capacitor, series reactor. So anyway, everybody know that improved power factor. Anyway, shunt capacitor is the right answer. So shunt capacitor, definitely I can match. And also in order to reduce the power factor, so in order to reduce the Faraday effect, what we are going to use? We are going to use the shunt reactor. That is also most popular to everyone. Now let us go through. So from this option will never comes. These two options can be ignored at a spot. So among these two options, which is the right answer? So reduce the current ripple, which is the right answer. For reduce the current ripple, which is the best answer? So you can go ahead with the series. So just identify which is the correct answer. Series reactor, correct? No, series reactor. So I can go ahead with reduce the current ripple. I can go for with the series reactor. See, that means B4. I have to go for B4. Then increase the power flow in the line. Increase the power flow in the line. I can choose which is the correct answer. So just identify. So just verify how to ignore the wrong answers. So try to reduce the wrong answer. Try to avoid the wrong answer. Now see, increase the power flow in the line. Definitely C3. So the right answer is option B. Option B is the right answer. Okay. So you have to try to filter out the wrong answer and save the time. That is very important. Okay. I hope you could understand how to avoid the wrong answers. Okay. I hope this video was useful. Do let me know in the comment section if you are having any queries. What are your favorite topics? What topic you like me to cover? Do you need any clarifications from my previous videos? Also, let me know any suggestions on improving this. Your support is the great motivation for me. And thank you for your kind support as of now. And I request you to keep supporting. So thanks again.